Hey everyone, Jonathan Blackwood here from Commercial Integrator, and we are here for another three questions video interview. Today, our guest is Maris Ensing from Mad Systems. Maris, thank you so much for joining us today.
You're very welcome. Nice to be here.
It's a pleasure to have you. We're focusing on digital signage this month, and right away I wanted to ask you about the Quicksilver product that you guys have that I've been hearing a lot about and seeing it being used in various locations. Could you tell me what Quicksilver is and how it came to be?
So Quicksilver is a new type of AV system. We started building it about 3 years ago, 3.5 years ago now. But it's kind of been in the making for longer than that. We have always wanted to go for a non-proprietary solution to AV and really try to concentrate on providing something that had a long-term life. So equipment that people like Intel make that we know we can get for as long as people continue to manufacture computers. It started, I think in reality, many years ago, because it's funny, we're looking at updating a system that we put in 16 years ago. The client has asked us to do an update. And as it happens, that also uses PC-based service, which we developed at the time. So Quicksilver came to be very early on, but it really started when we started noticing all of a sudden laser projector prices came down, monitors have became a commodity, and computers became smaller and smaller. And one of my guys was playing with some of our software on one of the tiny little computers and came to the conclusion that we could easily run video of one of these tiny little things. And so we started looking at wireless as a control protocol. We're not streaming, but we wanted to be able to control using wireless because a lot of money is always being spent on infrastructure cabling, which in most of our applications, nobody will ever see and nobody wants. And it's a lot of money, a lot of work. And so we got to the point where all of these kind of things combined to make us sit back and say, okay, let's have a look at this because there's some options here. And so we started Quicksilver and we've got to the point now where I think we've got some 40 or 50 individual components that make up the Quicksilver AV system.
I know that, or I've seen that another kind of technology area that Mad Systems has been focusing on is recognition technology-driven media delivery. Can you tell us about what this is and how Mad Systems came to be involved in it?
That is something we've, for many years in our normal market, people want to use RFID, they want to use barcodes to identify visitors and be able to... Mostly it's a case of when you have interactive to carry knowledge about who you're dealing with from station to station. And we started looking at that and decided to develop an infrared badge, which allows us to identify a lot of people within a given space simultaneously. It's kind of a multitasking kind of system where we could easily recognize 30 individuals in a given space. And we decided we didn't really like the overall way that it worked, in that you still have an object that you need to carry with you. You still have to give them out at the beginning and get them back at the end. It doesn't work outside. It doesn't work in locations where you haven't got a lot of control. And you need to clean all of this stuff and put anti-theft in and all that kind of thing. And the other thing that we didn't like is you could still walk up to a location and occupy that location, and you might be looking somewhere else and really not have a lot of interest in it. And we would still get signals from this badge, even though you might already be looking over there somewhere. And all of a sudden it dawned on us that really the way to try and hit this is to find a way that, point one, we needed to use something that we don't care if people take with them. And point two, it shouldn't need to take us to clean it and to look after it and to make sure that it didn't get stolen. And all of a sudden, it became very obvious that the only thing that really meets all of those parameters is people's faces. We don't care if they take them home. They don't tend to get stolen. and they don't take any cleaning on our end. So that became kind of a thought. And what we started doing is to start doing experiments with this, and it worked so well that we now have patents on using facial recognition to locate people within a space and to deliver media based on recognition. But not only facial recognition, we also started looking at correlating people with their cars, because going back to digital signage, it became very obvious to us that it's time that we no longer just take the scattergun approach to digital signage. It really is time that we start recognizing people and tailor content for them. And it goes beyond that. It's to do with wayfinding. You're in a mall somewhere. Wouldn't it be nice that if I wanted to go to a particular store from wherever I am, especially in those big malls where you've never been before, if there is a guidance system that tracks you through, that knows where you are and tells you where to turn left and where to turn right and optimizes that route for you. So there's all of these kind of possibilities that that became obvious when we started using facial recognition initially, and then obviously when we started putting in color recognition, because one of the things we wanted to do is to be able to recognize school groups. If you have a client who doesn't want to use facial recognition but still would like to recognize different school groups because there might be different ages and you want to deliver age-dependent content, there's still an option to do that. And then when it came to the digital signage end of things, it became very obvious that, you know, you're driving to Vegas, the road is empty, there's a great big billboard there. Why am I not making sure that that billboard puts the ad up for the hotel or for the show that we know that that person or these people in these cars might be interested in? And so it's become something that we've developed in the lab. We now, as I say, we've got patents on the technology, and we feel that it will provide an enormous benefit to digital signage and even places like trade shows. Let's face it, if you know who your biggest clients are, why not make sure that they get recognized rather than stand at the edge of the booth while you're dealing with somebody that you know is not really interested in your product or certainly isn't about to spend a lot of money on. So there's a whole host of applications for this technology that we believe will shape the way of both audiovisual and digital signage in years to come.
Yeah, I want to dig into that digital signage aspect of recognition technology. Is this going to fundamentally impact digital signage and change the way that digital signage systems are created moving forward, in your opinion?
I believe so. If you look at how we're bombarded with irrelevant ads all day long, and then you're starting to look at what has happened in the digital world. I mean, if you look at something on your computer, not too long afterwards, funnily enough, there's a whole bunch of ads that get very specific to what you might have been looking at. You know, I'm looking at an article about a new car and I'm interested in a particular car. And all of the sudden, there's ads that start appearing that target that that particular interest and similar devices. Obviously, there is a way to build up a little bit of knowledge about that person. You don't know who they are. You don't need to know who they are. But if you know what their interests are, you can do a better job advertising and targeting that advertising budget properly at people who either are interested in your product and may want to consume it, or at people who are looking at competitive products and you know how, you know, you want to get to people that are already interested in that product or service or whatever it is, and you want to put something special up that'll make them more interested in yours than anybody else's. So yes, I believe it'll have a fundamental impact on the way that we're doing things. It's going to take a little while. One of the big problems that we're obviously having with recognition systems is privacy. And people are very concerned about their privacy, and quite correctly so. And the idea of linking the whole country together and, you know, just being recognized wherever you go is not particularly appealing to a lot of people. And that's why we've come up with the concept of anonymous recognition. it doesn't really matter who you are. If I know what you're interested in, I don't need to have your name. I don't care where you live. I just want to know that, hey, this person is interested in these things, and therefore I'm putting that ad on. A very simple example of that is that whenever I go and get gas, I've got that annoying monitor in my ear making noises about stuff that I have zero interest in. Why not make it so that when I get out to the car, it's recognized my car, so it already knows who's going to be driving that car most of the time. Why not make sure that it targets what I might be interested in on that screen, so that there is actually a purpose from the advertiser's point of view? They're not just throwing money at it. And from my point of view, having something that isn't just annoying would also have a great benefit. I mean, quite frankly, I wish they turned the things off until they could do something a little bit more meaningful with that yelling in my ear while I'm getting gas. And that's you know, a clear example of how I feel that there are, you know, even when you just look at it in a fairly kind of high level overview, how many possibilities there are for this kind of technology to be used. And it goes way further than that. I mean, it goes obviously beyond digital signage. People love going on cruises. Why do people love going on cruises? Because the customer service, right? So if I've gone to one bar and I've always ordered a dirty martini with three olives, and I go to another bar, why am I not being recognized with a, hey, Maris, would you like your usual? These are the kind of possibilities that we can do with recognition technology. And in fact, with anonymous recognition, in that case, it had my name, but it doesn't need to. By making sure that we target our customer service properly and to make sure that people actually get a benefit from it. And in the case of our systems, because we're not using, you know, the Microsofts, the Amazons, the Googles, our systems are fully isolated, self-standing systems. So there is no link to the outside world necessary. We can run without an internet link. We can run in a locked cupboard and keep that whole thing out of people's way. And we can scrub the database whenever we want to do it, once a day, twice a day, whatever you want to do. So there are possibilities of using facial recognition, both for locating people within a space in locations like theme parks and similar, you know, shopping malls, that kind of thing, as well as facial recognition being used for media delivery. There's some obvious possibilities, and there's some very obvious advantages of using this technology.
Yeah, I mean, between Quicksilver and this new technology, it sounds like there's a lot to be excited about at MAD Systems. If anyone in the audience wants to learn more about your organization and what you can provide, how can they find you?
Well, there's obviously the website, www.madsystems.com. And the other thing is that I put quite a bit of information out on LinkedIn. So get in touch with me on LinkedIn and link in and see what we're up to, because there's always new stuff coming out. And if you want to know immediate information, contact either me or somebody in our office, and we can get the brochures out to you that talk about all of this technology. There's a lot of data about what we've done, and our portfolio of existing jobs that use Quicksilver is getting larger and larger. And there are some very obvious links on our website of projects that we've done recently that are full Quicksilver systems, including a traveling exhibit, which is another very nice application for wireless technology, because you can imagine how much different it is to have a traveling exhibit where you don't have to worry about all of that infrastructure wire. So yes, it's very exciting for us. I really see some interesting stuff happening over the next couple of years, because we're still developing new peripherals and new additions.
Yeah, I encourage everyone to check out MAD Systems. I know that at Commercial Integrator, we're always excited when we find out MAD Systems is working on something new and to see what you guys come up with. So Maris Ensing of MAD Systems, thank you so much for joining us for 3 questions.
You're very welcome, and thanks for having me.